session. So if anything you would like to see later from this presentation, that will be available in the recording that we can send to you after the session has been completed. There might join some other people maybe during the presentation, but in order to keep the time that we have reserved for this session, I will just start this webinar. This is actually our second webinar given by Cloud Team, presenting Financial Force and also Salesforce in this presentation. The subject from this webinar is from CPQ to billing. So the idea is to show the features and the process, actually how to derive from a quotation to a billing contract, and also how to manage the billing contract in order to be able to make your invoicing, your sales invoicing, how to manage, for example, projects that are part of a CPQ configuration. And that will lead finally, of course, to the correct sales invoices. So this is the subject of this this Cloud ERP webinar, which I would like to give to you. Of course, there can be questions, even during the session, if you really think, well, I cannot follow you anymore, and it will probably will stop you of losing your interest in the session, please let me know that I can just quickly explain a little bit more about the session. But the idea is actually that I'll do a short introduction, and then we'll describe the process that we will demo you this morning. Then I will give you the demo in about 40 minutes, and in the end, we will have also time for, let's say, general questions. But as I mentioned, if you have difficulties to follow the process, please let me know, and I will try to explain a little bit more better how to actually, what we are presenting and what we think is a very powerful solution on the Salesforce platform. So the introduction, actually, very short, is the introduction is that we are presenting Financial Force applications based on the standard Salesforce application. And Financial Force is an app on the app exchange of Salesforce. Financial Force is the biggest app exchange partner for Salesforce with more than 1,000 customers. Itself has about 700 employees in offices in the US, UK, and also in another place in Europe. Financial Force is specialized in the ERP part of applications for Salesforce. So everything that is around the business processes that follow up on the quotation or the sales cycle, which has been introduced by Salesforce. So Cloud Team itself is being specialized on the Financial Force stack. So as we are covering project management, the resources that are part for HR, the billing contracts and revenue recognition, is all linked then to the sales invoice in order to have the information all at a customer level. So the customer, based on the CRM principles of Salesforce, is always centric. It's always the place actually where you can start your journey to make analyses, to create transactions, to create leads, to create opportunities, to create invoices, to check actually your credit management. Everything is around the customer, and all those applications will tie in each other to show you the information that is needed without making it duplicate. As I mentioned, Cloud Team is then the expert that is where we have created a lot of implementations already with finance, in HR, with projects, CRM, and supply chain management. And we are a preferred partner for Financial Force to work in Europe, primarily in the Netherlands, but also in other European countries like Switzerland, Sweden, Denmark, France, Spain, and we cover even more countries around outside Europe. Cloud Team also is a developer of specific Financial Force apps, for example, an app to integrate SEPA to scan invoices of payable invoices, intercompany cost allocations, and we have some marketing apps created. So this is quickly an introduction of Financial Force and Clouting Company on the Salesforce platform. But actually, to come to the subject of this webinar, the CPQ to billing process, what I would like you to show is based on a kind of an example that will have all kind of elements in itself to easily detect how powerful the quote that consists of different subjects can be managed in Financial Force to actually control your process of the billing, the creating sales invoices, and also to manage your project. So this demo is created around an example of one of our products, which is called the Invoice Scan product. And when we actually sell this Invoice Scan product, and of course, I'm also now promoting my product, but actually the idea is to show you that the Invoice Scan, if we sell it to a prospect, to a customer, that we actually have four different type of products in together in this Invoice Scan. The first product actually is that we have a kind of installation fee. So the implementation cost, which is linked to a kind of a user-based scenario. So based on the number of users that will start using the system, we created a one-time cost that should be invoiced only once, of course, which is actually to cover all the implementation tasks that we need to perform. So actually, there's a one-time invoice that needs to be created, and there's also a project that needs to be managed. So in the time that we want to create the from the order, finally the contract, we also would like to create directly a project to manage the task to actually execute this project. So that's already a complex task in itself, is how to actually create from this quotation directly a billing contract line to actually manage the sales invoicing and to create the project to control the time registered by the implementation team. The second thing is actually that we are doing a training. We actually quote this training as a separate line, although it's maybe part of the project, but it's also a one-time cost with some standard price list based on the number of, on the size of the company. The second or the third thing actually is then the subscription fee. So based on the number of employees, we can have a price table that will actually calculate then automatically the subscription fee and propose that in the quotation. And this is done based on the number of employees by company. So it's important already to record this number of employees somewhere during the lead process in order to have the quotation program to detect the right price tier for the subscription. And then finally, the fourth element in this quote that I will show you in a minute is the price per scan. So every time you will get an invoice scan, you send a PDF from a supplier, which will be received by your system. A scan will be, let's say, produced from this PDF, and this scan actually has a cost of 30 cents. Now, this is a variable. So every month, the invoice will be can be created based on the exact number of scans that has been processed for this client. And then we need to make a kind of invoicing based on the exact the consummation of these scans. So this is actually the four elements that I will show you in the quote that all have different type of sales invoice lines and show you how we can actually manage those lines. So I don't know if there's any question about this this example that I will use. So that will help you, of course, also to understand what I would like to create or get out of the system once I'm finished. So the next step is actually then the process. So these are the steps that I will show you during the demo in the system, how Salesforce and Financial Force together will be able to manage this process. So the first step actually is the lead. That is where it starts. we will receive a kind of a call or an email or via a seminar or maybe on a workshop that someone is interested in our product. And we will register that as a lead and we will start to work on those leads. The next step is actually when this lead becomes an opportunity. So there's really a contact that the customer starts like, okay, I might want to start ordering your system. We create an opportunity. And the lead will be converted into an account, which is actually a registration of the company and also together with the contact details of the lead. So we will know the email address and the phone number and more information that we need to do. And once this opportunity will be followed during the sales cycle, there will be a time, hopefully, that the prospect will say, well, can you create a quote for me? And that time we start working with Salesforce Steelbrick or the CPQ module from Salesforce to actually create this quote and to configure this quote. And the more we can already automatically create this quote based on things like the number of employees in the company, or maybe to package it as a deal, will help us to make standard quotes without, so everyone can start creating quotes in the future. Now, this quote actually can have also various stages that you maybe discuss a discount for a customer, or there's another change in the quote which needs to be, so you have different versions of the quote, but finally, the customer will, or the prospect will accept the quote and say, okay, and then we'll create actually the sales order. And the sales order is then the finalized quote with the product information, which has been then agreed on the with the customer. And this sales order is the basis actually to create two things based actually on the products that are selected. So the sales order will then be created into a billing contract if there's a kind of subscription part of this sales order. And in this situation with the subscription fee, there's a monthly subscription. So this needs to be set up in a billing contract. And if the product also has an element of a project in it, it also creates a project based on a template. So actually step 5 and 7 will be created at the same time. But in the way of showing this process, it looks like they 7 starts actually after the sales invoicing, which is not normally not the situation. Because this billing contract will lead to sales invoices, the sales invoices will then be invoiced based on the start dates of some of the products. And the project, of course, will be helped to manage, for example, the implementation, to manage to set up training, to search for the right resources to give this training. And then finally, the people can start making that time, spending that time on it. So you can control actually your, the price that you discussed with the customer for this project. So these are the elements that I will show you now in this demo. So far, maybe any questions? Because now I will switch over to the system. So I've now started Salesforce and the Salesforce screen, and I hope everyone can see my screen, the switch between the PowerPoint and Salesforce. And if you're new to Salesforce or to Lightning, I'm now showing an app that consists a couple of functionalities in FinancialForce and Salesforce that are grouped together. And I group this together in what I call the CPQ to Billing Central, to Billing Contract Integration. And in this process, I try to follow my steps from leads to accounts and opportunities, to quotes, to orders, sales orders to contracts. And those contracts will become billing documents. This is another term for sales invoices. And then I've got projects that will be created. I've got products that are actually, of course, part of my setup. I want to see dashboards, and I've got my resource planner for my projects. So I group them together, and in your situation, you can always maintain your own way of managing the functionalities, because you still got Viaday the nine dots. You can find any application or any functionality within this app launcher feature. So this is actually the start. I want to start actually with a new lead, and a lead is something that is just the first information you will receive whenever you you start actually with my leads. So I created some leads, but not today. So new leads actually, and I'm just checking if I'm in the right environment, because I created already some leads and now I'm just missing them. This is the leads, I think. Okay. Here are my leads that I started actually to register at the system. So those leads actually are containing some generic information. This lead, if I check the activity page where I can log my calls, where I can create tasks what I would like to follow up. Those tasks, by the way, will appear in my screen whenever I'm working, and there will be a reminder this task will pop up. I can create events, or I can even start emailing to this customer or to this prospect from the lead system. The lead itself is can be seen in the details page, where I will register a name, a company, and a title. I want to see, of course, the phone and the email. If it's a hot lead, I will register some address information, and as I mentioned, the number of employees, which will be important for the CPQ process. Could also be that based on a kind of the company size, maybe detected by the annual revenue, could be a source for CPQ to calculate certain discounts. A lead source could help, for example, to create in the CPQ rules for partner discounts if it would be in a referral by a partner, another information, and of course the description where it already starts, like there's an interest in the Infoscan scan solution and they use already Finance Force Accounting and Salesforce CRM. So this kind of information will just be detected, can be followed from different statuses, from new to nurturing, and then either you can unqualify them or you can convert them. And convert is the step where Financial Force and Salesforce will create an account, a contact, and an opportunity. And this opportunity would have then some more information. For example, I will add the InfoScan app as being the opportunity that we would like to create. So the system also is checking whether there is already an existing account for this. So there's one account matched. So I can also check for, well, then select this this account. So don't create a duplicate account. And I convert this lead. So this is the first step, actually, to maintain the system. Salesforce will show you the information that the account has been created, the contact. So there's a new contact is created and the opportunity is created. So you can continue to go to your leads. You can create a task for someone else or for yourself, or we can just go directly to the opportunities. So the opportunities that is created is the basis actually to continue the process. So the opportunity for Bioness that I just activated again has several steps for the sales process, and those steps can be will also determine your sales funnel in order to show the percentage of revenue that can be expected. This is all shown on those dashboards that we have created by Salesforce, which I will also show you later. The dashboard itself, and maybe before I just go, there's a lead dashboard that I would like to show you. That's the company performance. So the leads actually will show you things that, for example, the number of leads by lead source, which is an interesting report where you can see. Well, this is not that interesting. So the leads by lead status shows that there's still one lead that is new, and there are already quite some leads that are qualified and are being changed over to an opportunity. So from this dashboard, we'll just check on the opportunities. We open one of the opportunities that has been now in a prospecting phase. The opportunity itself now, since we are using SteelBrick CPQ, is not that important for us, because we will focus more on the quote part. But things that will be interested on the opportunity when you start, before even creating a quote, is entering, for example, some details like type of, is it new business or is it an existing customer? The amount that can be created. So there could already a kind of a guess from the sales manager that, well, I expect that this will be about 10,000 revenue account on a yearly basis. There's not that much information that we would like to already keep on the opportunity, as we are using the quotation module to become more useful for the whole system. As you can see also on this element, it's already multi-currency. We set up the account as being a euro account. So on the account itself, if I open the account on a new tab, you're able to see that the account itself can be determined what type of, also here go to the details. If it's a euro trading currency, it can have links to Financial Force general ledger accounts, dimensions, sales information, and VAT information, and it will show you the type of information that has been generated by the lead. So the lead will actually then fill the billing address information and other information that I kept on the lead, like the phone number and the number of employees. So that actually is why the amount already detects that it's in euro, because euro is the trading currency for this customer. We're still in the prospecting phase, but let's say that we're marking it now as the proposal phase. So we will skip some steps. And then we'll create actually a new quote from this opportunity. So the customer is ready to receive a quote, and thanks, Lucien. We will send to you the recorded version. So the quote actually is linked to the opportunity. And the first part is actually that we created as the primary quote. So this is the quote actually that is creating, that is the basis for even new releases of the quote. And I cannot save it. And it will already use all the information that is on the opportunity to create this quote information. So you can see the sales rep. If I don't want to change the sales rep, it's just taking the primary contact, like Frans, the sales rep, this is myself, Ralph. And it is using, for example, information that is additional, like the address information, the ship-to information, all directly if you don't change things on the detail list. So this is the first quote actually that's been created. There's no contract yet, so once the quote will be finalized into a sales order and a contract, all this information will then also be visible on the quote. And you can actually, the whole system is made relationships between all these related elements and objects, like contracts, like sales invoices, like projects. All information can be visible from one object to the other. So this quote actually is something now that we can create some quote lines. And the quote lines will be filled, because there's nothing being created, is by just use the edit lines, where we can select products that are that could be linked to this quote. As I mentioned, we will have different price books. There's no lines, of course. we can start with adding products. Now the products are selected based on the price book. So if there was a price book available for 2018, but the product didn't have a price in this price book, it will not be appear in this product selection list. And as there are quite a high variation of products in the system, you can use filters actually to determine what type of product you would like to see. So the invoice scan is abbreviated by the payable invoice scan PISA. And if I apply this filter, it will only show me the elements that I just showed in the example, where we have an installation cost, which is listed on the list price. We have a monthly subscription, and because the number of employees was higher than 100, the list price is now selected from euro 100 to 200. There's a product price per scan, which is 30, and there's a training selection. So I just tick all those products and list them actually as being the product itself. Now, actually, one thing I would like to make a small sidestep is the product itself. I'm just opening another session and just select the product. So the product itself already has some elements that will help me in the next steps to create the right sales invoices. So, for example, the scan. In the scan, I have a product code. This helps me actually to quickly identify some groupings of products. There's a sales revenue account linked to it, naturally to create sales invoices and then post them also to my finance ledger. But more important is also then the billing type. So this billing type is linked to the billing contract. And it shows me the type that actually this product is a recurring project. A product which will be monthly recurring, but it's a variable product. So every month there could be a different number of scanned documents. So therefore, the billing contract in the future needs to know the exact number of this of the scanned products. So that's happening for this product, but for other products, for example, the installation fee, it's just a one-off type of billing type. So this setup in the product will help me to actually create a correct billing contract in the future. So keep that in mind when we are going to the next steps. So this is actually the quote. Go back to the quote, and let's say on the contract lines, I want to make a quote where the customer has give an indication that they probably will consume about 4,000 scans a year for this contract. So they to update the product, I will just make a change and I will just make a kind of an estimation of the number of scans for this product. There's a kind of warning here that on the background, the system is calculating the exact number of the update line. So sometimes there's a kind of a recognition that to calculate the correct numbers, it is waiting for some time. But you see here that the amount is now being changed to 8,100 based on the price book. On the related list, I actually see the quote lines. It's not updated yet, but now you can see that the 4,000 has been updated and it's now creating a number again of about 1,200. And we see the other lines, which still can be amended based on the quote. So this quote actually can then be, if I'm going back to the quote, can then follow several steps. We can actually create an quotation document. We can, if there are prices updates, refresh prices. Even quotes can be created by importing lines if they are really complex quotes. The quote terms can be created, but finally, the next step I would like to show you is the order. Because the order actually is the place where we would like to actually start finalizing the order in order to make a contract. And this is the step actually that I was showing you here, that we are now in the CPQ part to configure the price quote. And the next step is actually to make the order. So on the order, I'm just, for the sake of time, is trying to go to an order that is already created. Is an order where, again, the product's being taken over from the quote. This order has already been activated, so it's been created at the time to make a contract, a prepare the contract. And at the same time, when the order is created, it's creating a project. So this contract that is linked to this order can then be used to make the invoicing. So the order actually is only a kind of a step in between the quote and the contract, because not always a quote will lead to a contract. It could also be just a one-time cost that needs to be invoiced. So there's no need actually to create a whole contract setup just only for a one-time fee for training or something. Also, if it's only a project which will be invoiced based on time and materials, there's also no need to make a contract because it will be invoiced directly from the project. But if there's a combination in this kind of a complex quotation where there is partly subscription billing and partly project services, then actually the sales order is just an intermediate stage from the quote to the billing contract. So therefore, I'm not spending too much time on the order itself, which is actually the finalized quotation. This can be used actually for another type of document where you you finalize your contract with your customer and actually start the whole operational cycle of sending the sales invoices, creating the services. Okay? So from this contract, we'll show you the contract that has been created. The pre-one contract. And actually, so far, it was all Salesforce apps, so the CRM and the CPQ app. And from the contract, we're actually now stepping into the world of Financial Force. As you can see, actually, by this little logo, this appears. So this contract is actually a status where we have, of course, a start and an end date. So it's a yearly contract. We can determine already that even the, although the contract starts at the 1st of July, we can even start billing at another date. So it could be sooner, it could be later. And there could be a kind of a renewal reminder that automatically will be created on a certain business rule that you set for this contract. And of course, the contract ends the 30th, so it's only 7 days reminder actually before the contract ends that something needs to be started. We see also that a company name is listed, and this is the company name, Cloud Team Company. In Financial Force, we can set up multiple companies. So although Salesforce is a kind of a table that works organization-wide, it's not limited to work in, every lead, every opportunity can be shared. But then when we create a sales invoice, it needs to be linked to a legal entity. And this legal entity is actually the company, in this case, Cloud Team Company, in order to make the sales invoice to the correct legal entity. And of course, you can see anything like related orders or other information where you would like to check. This contract needs to be activated. It can already be started to be activated automatically as soon as the sales order creates the contract. But there could also be a kind of step in between based on segregation of duties. But once it's active, it can only be changed based on creating a change request, which needs to be accepted, of course, by the customer. From this contract, actually, we have billing schedules. This schedule already will determine the number of invoices that can be sent out for this contract. But then actually, at the time the invoice will be created, which is the billing document, then actually the final information will be used about the correct pricing. As you can see, the quantity has been taken over from the sales order, which is a 1 monthly subscription. There's a 1 training fee. There are installation costs. But the scan is an amount that's actually not being filled in because it's the recurring variable. So these billing types being taken off from the product. And because it's a recurring variable, it is required to fill in on a monthly basis because the billing term is monthly. To fill in the details. And these details, for that we need to go to the we need to switch the page actually, because there are various ways that we can feed the system with those type of variable details. The details can be entered manually, and then I need to go to the contract lines. I check the contract lines then for the scan. So I open the scan contract lines, and on the scan contract lines, there's actually the consumation, so the related uses. So there are already scans being detected for July for 890, and in August there will be about 1275 scans. Well, this information can be entered manually, but can also be imported from other type of operational systems, or we use it directly from, let's say, Salesforce objects, where we record the number of scans by customer. But it's important to be aware that this information is related on the billing contract lines. So if I'm going back to the contract, and although I won't see the information on the billing contract for this recurring variable, it is information that is, let's say, on the background available to show that it's actually always need to be updated. Now, this billing document can now be created. So if it's active, we can now start creating billing documents. And this can be done for a wide group of contracts. So it's not for just for each contract you need to do this step by step. You can already do it for all the contracts that are in a certain range. And the system will determine actually what needs to be invoiced. So if I just start, because this is the first bill day, the 1st of June, till the end of June, and I want to make then a final, the document date should then also be the end of June or maybe the 1st of July. I can now create already in the background a batch job which actually create billing documents. Now, the billing document for this contract is now being created because there are not so many contracts at the moment outstanding, so it works quite fast. And based on the information, it will now detect the number of based on the setting in the contract, it will show the lines that needs to be invoiced to this customer. So it's the first month of invoices that will be sent out to the customer. The installation fee, the training fee, and the monthly subscription will be part of this billing document. This is actually the first step of the sales invoice. This sales invoice can then be either printed, emailed, and when it's marked completed, it will be posted to the general ledger and the sales ledger from your financial force accounting company. We can already create the second invoice. And if I'm back to the contract and I create a billing document for the next step, so I'm now starting to invoice from the next period. And it should be a little bit later, 1st of August. And I create a document. So the system is now checking actually what is being available for invoicing. There's a new sales invoice created, or new billing document. And if I open it, then actually there are only now two product lines invoiced. So the first one is the monthly subscription, because this is a monthly, this is not a one-off fee. So every month it will be invoiced, and it's now also showing the scans with the new users for the next month, the 1275. And this actually will then continue. So the system will control what will be invoiced at what stage, based on the information that has been set up on the contract, this contract. So therefore it will be less hassle to actually create the correct invoices based on the contract. Yeah, so this is the first step actually that shows the information creating sales invoices. But as I mentioned, that the installation and the training are part of a kind of a fixed price one-off fee. So these invoices will not be invoiced directly to the time will not be invoiced directly via time and material via projects, but we still need to actually control that those projects will be followed correctly. So there will be, I need, for example, to assign resources. I need to control that the budget that I've created, about this 5,500 for the installation, will not be exceeded by the time that my consultants will spend on doing actually the installation tasks. So therefore, I also, within Financial Force, I can control this part. And the invoicing in this situation will be invoiced directly from the billing contract, but on the project, and as I mentioned, from the sales for invoice, it's creating the project. So now I'm going to the app of the projects. I've got the project. The project is a fixed price because it cannot be invoiced. It will be invoiced already via a fixed price order. It's linked to the opportunity and the quote. It has also a start and end date, which I can, which is now determined on 1 month of doing this task. And there's a template copy to it. Template is not mentioned, but actually is a template to actually automatically create this project. And this template will help me already to predetermine the tasks. So first, what I would like to show you is there's a budget linked to it. And the budget should be here. So the budget comes from the sales order and a quote, which is actually the 5,500. And then there are 4 project tasks created from the template. And those tasks then actually will be scheduled in time. So for that we are using on the project task Gantt. There will be a message now because the demo is in a US zone and I'm in a European zone. So that's why sometimes days could be vary. But you can see that those tasks are now scheduled. Just show them in day settings so they look a little bit better in those weeks. So these tasks come from a template and actually those tasks already have some resource types linked to the different tasks. For example, this is done by a trainer. This task deployed to production will be a consultant. And as you can see, I already assigned actually a real in resource to the installation in the sandbox. So this task will be created and resource requests will be created. And those resource requests can then be followed up, for example, by the planner in order to make the right days that you would like to schedule actually the installation task for this project. And this resource planner, Siona, this is part of Financial Force PSA, the projects. So we have Billing Central as a module, or Billing Contracts. We have the Financial Force Accounting as a module, and the PSA is a module. You're welcome. So in my resource planner, I will see all my resources that could be assigned to projects, and I see their availability based from today. For this week, you see here the week calendar. So of course, red means that looking at the weekly time of 40 hours, they are quite full. I don't know why the 40 is green and 40 is red. I know because on the 4th of July is a holiday. So actually there are only 32 hours available in this week. So for US persons, this is actually already overbooked. If I want to filter a bit, then I'll just make a filter where I'll just filter on a kind of a region. I drag the filter region here and I filter only on the corporate region, apply the filter. And then actually I see already myself appearing. And well, this guy has still some time left to do this new project. And I even can check what is the project that he's now been booked for. So as I already mentioned that I was part of this project to install the invoice scan for Premon, you can will be able to see actually my assignment already in this part. And also based on this resource request, I can even swap resource or create or split the assignment in, for example, adding another resource to the same task or see the detail. So this is a very useful tool to manage my resources and then select actually the projects that I need to manage. So this project actually then can be used to manage my tasks, to manage the time that will be spent to the project, to create project reports to my customers. And actually it will show also the percent of complete, the hours that have been spent on it. At the moment nothing has been yet posted because the project is just started. With all these type of controls, I have to actually determine if my fixed price project is not exceeding my spending, or I maybe have to go back to the customer and say, Mr. Customer, something has not been anticipated, so we might need to change some of the amounts, or maybe we do it even faster. And finally, and then we are almost at the end of this short demo, is that the consultant can register its time. So therefore, I need to go to the time map. Normally, we can use a smartphone to enter time entries, smart entry app, or we use the time entry app directly from the system. So because of my assignment to this project, I can now enter the task, the actual hours that I've spent on this project, and I can just register the time, and I'm going to go to the next week and start again a new line where I can manage the time I'm spending for this project. I can also use actually my schedule. So if the resource planner is using actual the amounts and the days that you are using, you can also copy from the schedule your timesheet line, so you don't have to enter them. Once you have entered your time, you will be able to submit them, and based on the submission of the timesheet lines, your manager or the manager from the project will receive a task to actually complete or approve your timesheet lines. And once they are approved, then they will be able to see in your dashboard actually whether the costs and the from compared to the budget is still in line. So this information can all be shown on dashboards. Let's quickly, before we enter, go to a few of the dashboards that are created. For example, the quote to cash dashboard. Now we see the amounts of the status of the quotes and the net amounts. And we drill down and we'll be able to see all the quotes that have been created and what is the status of the different the various quotes that are created. We have the contracts actually, so based on the billing contracts, you will see each contract end date and the amounts that are for those end dates available. So we see here the active contracts that are created, the customers, we can see the billing documents, and we can also actually determine on the contracts whether the contracts are and where these billing documents are not yet completed, but there are some unpaid invoices. From these invoices that are created, they're still unpaid. So you can control even to the payment status of your invoices by contract. What is at the moment the situation for those contracts? And here you can see the billing by month, where you can determine what is the amount that we have billed based on our billing contracts. And just one last dashboard before we go to the questions and answers is the PSA, kind of a PSA dashboard. Let's take the PSA resource management dashboard. Here you can see the resource requests that are still open for different regions. We can check, for example, the different roles that are requested. And we can open this report and see that which roles are needed to actually for different type of roles that are linked to the projects. It's still loading. So I need the consultants, I need 4 consultants and 1 project manager and 2 trainers actually for the projects that are still upcoming for different projects that are available. Now these are just a few of all the tons of reports and dashboards that will be available, can be created and can be grouped together even on your homepage in order to show you the correct information. So I've spent about 15 minutes talking from my side. So I would like to invite you, if there are any questions that I can answer, to give you some more clarification about this process, to actually go from a quote of our InvoiceScan app solution to the billing sales invoices, to the billing contracts, and to a project, which is actually this process that we just have completed. So is there anyone that has a question in the time remaining for this webinar? And don't be shy. There are no stupid questions. I see my audio connection is lost, so I hope you can follow me or you can hear me. If there are no questions.
Yeah.
No questions. Yeah, okay. So, can you repeat, Ahmed?
No, just you asked if we are hearing you. I said yes, we are hearing you.
Okay, cool. I just received a message that my audio connection needs to be restored. Okay, I see a question from Siona. Is there an alternative to use projects in standard Salesforce? It depends a bit about what you would like to use for the functionality for projects. We are only focused on Financial Force projects, so we are specialized in the projects module from Financial Force, but there are different type of apps that also will be able to do project management. But Financial Force projects is directly integrated to Financial Force accounting. So therefore, and also with revenue recognition. So therefore we are, let's say, specialized on those modules. So I cannot help you with other alternatives yet, but probably on the App Exchange, you will be able to find out if there are more information. Any other questions that will... If there are no questions, then I'm really thankful for your attention. And you can always send an email or call me after the webinar to come up with more information. We will just record this. We have recorded this webinar so we can also distribute it to the person that have attended the session. Thank you for your time. And I hope it was useful information. And hope to see you next time when we created new webinars on the Financial Force modules on Salesforce platform. So thanks for your time and I wish you a very good day.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Ralph.
Yeah.
Thank you.